behind me is the 2005 Beneteau 57 center cockpit. This particular vessel is here at Marina Cortez on Harbor Island. So let me show you the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer.
So this is a very popular offshore cruiser. The Beneteau 57 center cockpit offers an amazing amount of space, great volume, safety at sea, and there has been so many things done to this particular yacht that really stand out. As you can see here, the cockpit itself is quite large, moving aft to that large traveler on the back deck, and this huge platform back here that really encompasses a lot of real estate. When docked or on anchor or at a mooring, the transom is electrically controlled by a little push button. This drops down, giving you great access into the vessel itself. As we move up forward, we have a shore power inlet, emergency bilge pump, 12-volt outlet, water inlet. We also have a hot and cold swim step shower. This top area slides right back and creates a nice big flush deck back here that you can also house a dinghy if so desired. One thing I'll point out to you is when you do that operation, this centerpiece out of the back of the boom will extend out, twist over, and you use this as kind of like your boom lift for, say, to bring your dinghy up here onto the back deck. You can always do davits or put it up on the foredeck with the spinnaker halyard. But again, that is an option here. We have two large lazarette lockers, both starboard and port side. Underneath here, this is where the decommissioned water maker is. Nice stern rail seats, barbecue. And as you can see, the owner has done all custom solid stainless steel lifelines around the vessel. I left the covers on, but these are varnished tow rails. We have varnished cap rails all along the edge here of the cockpit that really stand out. Newer canvas as well too. And what's really unique about this is it has the lower hard windshield. Moving up forward, again, you can just see how comfortable, safe this is. We have inboard shrouds, a large foredeck area, lots of hatches to let a lot of natural light in, and also ventilation is key. Underneath this hatch right here is a large sail locker. We have the Celdene bowsprit for asymmetrical spinnaker, our anchor locker, and a really nice stainless steel anchor up forward of that. The teak decks are in beautiful condition. They have been replaced recently. Instead of the quarter inch teak decks, they've been replaced with a half inch thick teak deck. So a really nice upgrade, along with the tape drive UK sails. Both head sail and main sail have been replaced with the UK tape drive. Triple spreader mast, radar reflectors, radar. At the very top of the mast is our wind point, wind speed. And again, as we carry back aft, nice wide side decks, lots of opening ports throughout the cabin. Again, ventilation is very key and it really exudes that. As we make our way back aft, you can again get a profile how large this aft deck truly is. And moving up into the cockpit itself, again, amazing amount of cockpit space there. Now there's two additions. You can have the wheel here in the back or up forward. Now, my personal preference is having it up forward. One thing I really like about that is it leaves this cockpit space all to your guests, and it puts you up here as kind of a motor sailor, feel and situation. The other thing that I like about being here is you are a little bit closer to the dock, so your visual of docking is a little bit easier in my opinion. But a nice wheel here, throttle controls. We have our bow thruster controls here, E80 chart plotter, autopilot, wind, depth, speed. Forward of that are our fuel tank gauges. There are three fuel tanks on this yacht. And then again, we have our compass, we have our engine, temperature, oil pressure, RPM gauge. There are currently 1,696 hours on this Yanmar. And again, it is really well kept. But again, huge cockpit, lots of seating, lots of space. I've put these covers on, but these are beautiful high gloss varnished cap rails. So it really just exudes, you know, a rich quality when you're on board. As we come down below, you're gonna see the beautiful high gloss flooring,
nice large salon here. We have tons of seating off to the port side, a large salon table off to the starboard side, kind of a love seat bench couch over here with its own table insert, which is kind of nice. Our nav station off to starboard. And here at the nav station, we have our stereo VHF multi-repeater Xantrax inverter charger, our autopilot remote control, and a second GPS plotter display located there. But again, beautiful, nice, open, airy, high-end, a real rich feel with this wood. What I also like is just the attention to detail with like this leather inlay here. We have an ice maker behind this cabinet right here. Additional storage, and then just after this is our chef's galley. So in the chef's galley itself, we have a refrigerator, a freezer, double stainless steel sinks, lots of countertop space. Right here, this is our washer for dishes. But again, great use of space here. Storage above the microwave, and really ideal. Deep freezer there. Four burner stove and oven. And again, this is a really nice chef's galley. It's out of the way, so if you do entertain, your guests are all in board here. So again, it keeps that separate, which I like in my opinion. Okay, looking forward is our twin identical berths. And so both starboard and port are identical, and there are storage underneath all of this, a nice center wall that divides them. This is a, I guess a modified twin bed in a sense, but really accommodates two people nicely. There's air conditioning, heating in all cabins. It has its sharp flat screen DVD television here and its own head and shower compartment. I really like what they've done here with this kind of smoked baby blue glass, and they've incorporated that into the shower compartment. Now, what's unique about this is this shower compartment is shared by both forward heads. So I'll show, actually, the easiest thing, I guess, is to walk you through it. But it's a nice shower compartment here. You know, with this door closed, you know, you have plenty of room. Your faucet fixture is located right here. And again, you have a nice, easy access into, you know, which cabin you're staying into. But here we are moving aft. You're into this head compartment. Again, this is an identical cabin. These are quiet flush, push-button electric toilets. Really beautiful countertops. And just what they've done with the woodwork and just the attention to detail is pretty stunning. This gives you an aft view of this twin berth here. Again, air conditioning controls. They have their own hanging locker, storage, overhead opening hatches, and just overall a nice feel. Here's another look into the salon looking aft. Now we're gonna go down the hallway. One thing that, again, is kind of unique about this is you actually have a true dedicated day head. So this is your day head. It can be used as a shower if somebody's sleeping in the, you know, the lateral cabin here, but true day head. This is an electric toilet underneath that little bench seat there. We have our electrical panel located here. Engine room access, which is pretty impressive. I don't have the light on, but this gets you access into the engine room. So we have the Yanmar engine up forward, dual Raycore systems, generator here. It's all in a nice sound shielded engine compartment. And then directly across from that is, we're using it here as storage, but again, you have hanging lockers on both sides here and a nice single berth. So it's a nice cabin. If you have a crew, that would be a great space. Otherwise, you can dedicate that for storage, laundry room, whatever you so choose. Now we're going into the aft master cabin, and not a lot of yachts really have this under that 65 feet. And that's what this Beneteau 57 really exudes in, is this amazing aft cabin. Centralized, you know, king size bed, really well down, lots of headroom, lots of overhead opening hatches, and storage is abundant. We have a large hanging locker closet here. Tons of storage, cabinetry all throughout, off to the port side, and your own walk-in head shower compartment.
electric quiet flush toilet, that same beautiful smoked baby blue glass, and a full walk-in shower as well too. I always do this so you can kind of feel what it's like, but yeah, pretty nice size, decent, you know, shower compartment. Moving your way back aft, I'll give you another kind of perspective of the aft cabin. Just what it really has to offer here. Large seating area off to the starboard side, forward-facing vanity with additional storage as well too. And then again, we're walking back down through the hallway into the salon of the vessel. Well, we covered a lot of yacht, 57 feet to be exact, or maybe just a little over that, in less than 10 minutes. And I know I skipped over a lot of things, but I hope you found it to be helpful and informative and enough information to want you to come down and actually see this particular vessel in person. Again, it's here at my office on Harbor Island. Easy access. It is absolutely pristine. The vessel itself is in really good condition for its age, and I truly think it's worth taking a look at. If you're looking at a serious offshore cruiser or a very comfortable boat to live aboard or do extended cruising or just eventually, you know, going offshore, I would take a serious look at this particular yacht and contact me at any time, day or night. If you liked the video, I hope you give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this. Thank you again. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.